Well, she is a showbiz survivor, and in the past 4 months, entertainer Maria Venuti has proved that she's also a fighter after suffering a debilitating stroke. Today is Maria's birthday, and last weekend to celebrate, she made her return to the social scene at a party in her honour. Her daughter Bianca graciously allowed our cameras to attend the event, and Maria's close friend and Studio 10 showbiz reporter Craig Bennett has this exclusive update on her progress.
Come on! I ain't what you do, it's how you do it. Some
girls, they like candy. She's the larger-than-life, besequined, bespangled, befeathered and beloved Aussie showbiz icon who's been lighting up the stages and screens for over 55 years.
Does that mean I have to get rid of my sleeves?
Maria Venuti is in a critical condition in an induced coma surrounded by loved ones.
But late last year, Maria's life took a shocking turn when she became the target of an obsessed stalker who kept turning up to her Sydney home.
So Mum called me and was very upset, was stressed out about the stalker out the front and said, I feel sick, I feel like I'm having a stroke. I called the police and by the time I called back, she was unconscious.
Big-hearted, larger than life, Maria Venuti is now in the fight of her life.
You don't want to believe it. We were just praying that she would live.
How did you feel when you were in the ambulance with your mum?
We were pretty sure it was a stroke. It was just about how bad a stroke, what's possible, what's recoverable. I was praying for the clot type of stroke, which 85% of strokes are, but they sort of said, look, it looks more like a bleed. They then said it's one of the worst bleeds they'd ever seen. That first 2 days was so scary. But on the other side, you know, it was also about, you can do it, you can do it, don't worry, it's going to be okay, because if you believe it's not going to be okay, I don't think that's helpful for anyone.
It goes to waste.
But sure enough, over the coming weeks and months, Maria's condition slowly but miraculously improved. All the while, Maria's devoted daughter Bianca never left her mum's bedside.
4 months into her recovery, some big milestones have been hit, so she can eat again. She doesn't have any tubes, but she's still got a long way to go in terms of things like being able to talk, cognitively understand, fatigue, and physically, you know, she's paralysed down the right side, so don't know how far we can get to there.
Over the years, this incredibly vivacious woman has raised over $30 million for an array of charities across Australia. To celebrate her birthday, 200 of her nearest and dearest gathered to cheer on her progress and salute her big day.
Put your hands together for the one and only Maria Venuti!
She bends over backwards to help a lot of people. She's very big on the charity scene, and I know this has really hurt her and her family, so I'm very pleased to be able to come along here today and just do a tiny bit, as you have, to support Maria.
What we've all been through these last few months and watching her get better and better, and it's just so wonderful to see her out and about and just to be able to see her friends and be here with all of us. It's very special.
And while we all enjoyed celebrating the return of one of Australia's most flamboyant characters, for Maria, the day marked an incredible milestone on her long road to recovery.
For her to be able to put a frock back on and get the eyelashes out and the red lips and just be her. Because when you're in hospital every day, sometimes, you know, you've got to remind her, you're still you, and she knows it.
You have the dedication and the determination to bloody fight through all these challenges, and it's ridiculous what's been thrown at you, and it's not fair. 50% of people who have little strokes get depressed, let alone what Mum's been through, and Mum just keeps going and just keeps smiling.
How do you stay so positive?
I think to me it's like there's no other choice. You have to be positive because the other option to me just didn't exist. At one point they said, you know, do you want to do surgery on her brain to drain it? And I said, well, what's the other option? There was no other option. The other option is goodbye. So it was always about fighting, about proving, about trying to keep Mum happy and stable and okay, and I'm conscious that there's a long road to go and they're still not giving her a great prognosis, but we're going to just show what's possible, because they said if anyone can do it, it'll be her.
We are right behind her, and we know as well that Maria is watching this morning. So on behalf of everyone here at Studio 10, we want to wish you a really happy birthday and a speedy recovery. Happy birthday, darling.
Yeah, we love you.